Hello boys and girls, Mike here, one go ShortPlay. Today we are playing The Adventures of Lolo 2. It was that popular, it generated a sequel. I guess I was wrong, this sort of game that uses all these puzzle mechanics from various other puzzle games must be quite popular. They haven't even changed the logo. They've still got that same bit of colour clash on the corners of the L's. The graphics are the same. That annoys me, that they haven't changed the graphic style at all. Again, the little pink one's been kidnapped and the blue one's got rescued. Really? They haven't changed anything except this is just like it. This is like a PD game on the Amiga. It's basically more of the same. More of the same. Have some more levels, 40 quid. Do you know what I mean? I don't know about this. I didn't really like the first one that much and I don't really like this. Let's find out. It's exactly the same. Not a scrap of new graphics, just different levels. I guess if you were into the first one, you'd be into this. It's a saving grace that there's no Lolo 3, at least I think there's not. I hope there's not, because it means that people have had enough by this point and weren't willing to invest in the third one. Which is fine by me, because the push things around mechanic is boring. I don't know. If you might be into that. You might be cleverer than me. I got really bored. I got tired quick. Even when I was doing it in Tomb Raider in 3D, they were the low points of the game for me. That's clearly death. Oh yeah, that's right. I can kick him. Skulls are clearly death. The other mechanics, the ones from Bubble Bobble, put them in a bubble and hit them off somewhere. That's cool, that works for me. It's quite fun. Uh-oh. Oh, wow. I like the baddies kind of come to life when you've completed the level, you've got to find the exit. I like that element. But it wasn't done brilliantly with many of the baddies. Just messed it up. I don't like the fact that you've got a suicide button for when you've messed it up, which you inevitably do. I can't be bothered figuring out that puzzle there. I just cannot be bothered. There's better things to be doing with my time. I don't even think you can get to that, can you? If I push that down there, no. I hate this stuff. Oh, no! Suicide. So sick of that. I don't hate the game. It's a well-made game. The first one was. I think it's a bit cheeky of them to just use all the same graphics and create another environment out of the same assets. I don't think that's fair on the user, on the player. Oh, I pressed the wrong button. I was really up for timing that right now. Yeah, I don't think that's fair on the player to not add anything new, except levels. This is just level design, isn't it? It's like half the job of making a game. I've got no weapon. What happened there? I've got no weapon. I'm not in love with this game. You may have guessed. It's just not my thing. There are genres I love and games I love. And I've seen a few on the NES so far that I've been like really wild by. This isn't one of them. And there's, to be honest, considering I started playing this on someone's claim that there's so many great games on the NES that it beats the pants out of the Master System. In a total fanboy kind of conversation, I guess. I put what they said to the test. That's what I'm doing. And at first I was really impressed. And right now, I'm just frustrated. Because I'm not finding that many good games. That was more of the same. If you're into it, it's great. If you're not, it's rubbish. The Adventures of Lolo 2 on the NES. Thank you for watching.